Good morning students. Today we are going to see another form of mechanical energy. As you know, there are two common forms of mechanical energy. First is kinetic energy and second is potential energy. Kinetic energy you have studied, its derivation also you have studied. Today you are going to study the potential energy. Now we are going to see what is potential energy. Now here, see, energy possessed by a body due to its position or change in position, or it is due to a change in shape, it is called as potential energy. Now here one example I will show you. This is a rubber band. Okay, now you can see it is in rest condition. If I will pull it, now there is a change in position also and change in shape also. Okay, now if now this stretched rubber band has some energy. If I will leave it, it will move. Okay, if I now this has energy, I am pulling it. When I will leave, it has energy. Okay, means it is due to its change in position or it is change in shape. So that's why this rubber band can be an example. This spring also, you can see, if you will see a spring, it is in rest condition. When you will stretch it, it will change in position and it will change in shape also. If you will leave it, it will come back again to the rest position. Means when you will stretch, it has gained some energy, and when you will leave it, it will come back to its rest position. Okay, now so the definition will be energy possessed by a body due to its change in position or shape is called as potential energy. One more example I can give you. You know the difference between the waterfall. You have seen the waterfall, how it falls from a height, and the water which is, and second I will tell you, the water which is moving normally, okay, in a slope, little slope. Okay, height differs. Here water is moving with a less slope, and another condition, waterfall which is falling from a great height. Now if you will say which one has great energy, the water which is falling from the great height, because here height matters. Okay, in this potential energy, the height matters. The water falls from a height, so the body has greater energy, means water has greater energy. And if the body which the water which is flowing in a slope, it has less energy. So here you can see the SI unit of this potential energy is joule, energy's unit is joule, kinetic energy's unit is joule, potential energy is also joule. Now here example, stretch rubber band. Just now I have show you string on the bow. Now this I will show you here. See here students, this is a bow. At normal condition, this dotted line I have shown, okay, without stretched. But when I am putting an arrow on this bow, that time you can see the string stretches. String stretches means what? Here now this bow and this string has energy. If I will leave the string, what happens? The arrow will move. Means at this, here change in position is there. You can see string was here, now here change in position, change in shape also of the string, and now it has gained some energy. When I have stretched it back, it has gained some energy, and when I will leave it, what happens? The arrow will move forward due to that energy. Okay, now at this condition, the bow and arrow has potential energy. Understood students, how this what is this potential energy? Now as I have told you, water stored in dam also, if you see the water which are stored in dams, and when it is allowed to move from the dams, that time you can see when the doors are open of the dam, that time you can see the water moves with a great force. Okay, and it has due to its height. When water falling from the great height, what happens? At that position, at height, the water has energy, and when it is falling down. Okay, and one more thing if you want to keep in mind, just I can give one more example of stone. Stone, you can see a stone lying on the ground, and the stone which is you know, now you have done this, you are throwing the stone upon the roof of your house, you know that it rolls and come down. Okay, so difference between the stone lying on the ground and the stone which is on the roof, there is a difference. Which one has the potential energy? The stone which is on the roof. After some time, what happens? It rolls down and falls down. Why it falls down? Because when you throw the stone, it has gained some energy. When it is at the height, or when it is at the roof of the house, it gains some energy and it falls down. Understood? So if any object is as high is at height, then what happens? It gains energy, and that energy, it is the potential energy which can make the object to move. Okay, now see, we are going to see, this is the potential energy. As you have seen the derivation of potential energy, we are going to see derivation, sorry, we have seen the derivation of kinetic energy. Now you will see the derivation of potential energy. The formula for the potential energy is PE equal to mgh. Okay, now we are going to see how this equation come. We are going to see the derivation of potential energy. Now see your diagram I have drawn here. Now see this. This is the surface of the ground. On this, a block is kept having mass m at a point A on the ground. Now what happens? See, I have lifted this and lifted at a height h, and I have kept the block at the height b. From the ground I have lifted the object, I have kept it at the height b. You can consider your table also. From the ground I have lifted and I have kept it on the table, and the height between these two is h. Understood? Here this is the point A at lying on the ground, this is the point B lying on the table after picking up and kept. When it was lying on the ground, what was the weight of the object? It is acting, work done was, it is acting perpendicular downward. You can see, you have studied weight of an object is equal to mass into gravity. Okay, acceleration due to gravity. So at this condition it is mg, and here weight is acting downwards, vertically downwards. Okay, you can see here weight is mg and it acts vertically downwards. Understood this? And now I have lifted and kept at the point B, means I have done work against the gravity I have done. Okay, here now it is at height h. Now see here, when object raised at certain height, its energy increases. As I have told you, the comparison between an object lying on the ground and object kept at a height h, its energy increases. Okay, if one more thing, if duster is lying down, it will not move, it will remain there only, it don't have any energy. If you are keeping it on the table, picking it and keeping on the table, when it will fall down, then what happens? Means it has energy, some energy is stored when you kept on the table. And if something happens, by mistake it fall down, then what happens? It goes against the, means it goes towards the ground due to the potential energy. Now here, see, in this one more concept is there, gravitational potential energy. Okay, in this you can see gravitational potential energy, what it is? It is work done in raising an object. As I told you, I am raising the object at certain height from the ground, and how it is? It is against the gravity. That is called as gravitational potential energy. Means potential energy it is, but it is getting potential energy, but it is against the gravity. That's why it is called as gravitational potential energy. Once more I will explain you this concept. Work done in raising the object at certain height from the ground against the gravity is called as gravitational potential energy. This is very important. Okay, now we will go to the derivation, remaining part of the derivation. See here, here you can see m, mass of the object, A is the point on the earth surface, B is the height point at the height h, and h is the height, as I have explained you. At this condition potential energy is zero, and at this condition what happens? And it is vertically, weight is vertically downward. Okay, and at point B we are going to see, here work done is against the gravity, I have explained you. Now what will be the work done? We see work done W equal to force into displacement. Okay, that is F into S. Now we, as I have told you, don't try to keep in mind all these things, just do what, see how the derivation came. As last equation I have told you, W is equal to F into S. Therefore what will be the F? First you will find the value of F, then S, then you will substitute and you will get the equation. So here F equal to mg. This you know. Why mg here? Here m, mass of the object, and here actually it is ma, but here it is acceleration due to gravity, that's why it is F equal to mg. It is given equation number 2. Second, S equal to h, means you know, It is from one position to another position, height is there. So S is considered as h, and putting these two equations, equation 2 and equation 3, in equation 1, you will get W equal to, instead of F, what I have taken? Mg, and instead of S, H is taken. So W equal to Mg into H, that is MgH. And this is work done, W equal to MgH. And work done is equal to gain in energy of a body. If you are doing a work on the duster, if you are taking from the ground and if you are keeping, means I have done the work on the object, and that is equal to the potential energy. Now you can see P equals to, that's why W equal to P, I have written here, work done equal to gain in energy of an body. Okay, so that's why instead of W I have taken here PE equal to MgH. Okay, understood? Now this was the derivation. Read this properly from the textbook. Try to write this in your notebook. Okay, write the equation, this potential energy, all these things till the derivation. And one more thing, as kinetic energy, here you write 6 examples of potential energy and you will send me today itself. Okay, thank you.